follow through. So that is the aim with this. Let's take one more at the back. Lady here with a blue hat.
I'm Sue Singapore. I'm an ambassador for the Sharon Project and the world's first burlesque woman from Singapore. And I've had to fight as an Asian woman for my art, since it's a cause that's really important to me. So obviously it's fighting for freedom of choice in its base form. I'd just like to ask, a lot of focus has been on children in schools, but with our charity, what we often find is for girls at university, that's their last chance where they're separated from their families, for them really to be rescued from the situations. And I was just wondering, in terms of universities, which often isn't talked about, it's always sort of children, which I appreciate, what would you suggest would be the best way to deal with that?
It's a very good point. We've got to make it easier for girls, whether at school or at university, to find someone independent to go to if they're worried that they're about to be subject to a forced marriage or some sort of marriage against their will. I would argue it's probably easier at university because there are organisations at universities, student unions and the like, that are there to help you. Whereas when children are in school, I think in the past they've always been more vulnerable because the schools haven't necessarily understood that these practices are going on and they've turned a blind eye. So you need to change it by making sure the schools are always switched on to this and people feel that not only can they go to their teacher, but actually the teacher has a responsibility to help them. And at universities, make sure that in every case there's somewhere for people to go. But at universities, people do have a great independence, perhaps from family, so they can object if they're about to be forced into something that they don't want to do. I think I'm afraid I'm going to have to leave it there. I really enjoyed coming today. We've got the Deputy Prime Minister coming to close the conference this afternoon. He speaks fluent French, Russian, Dutch and Spanish. And so you can put him to the test. But this government is absolutely united across the coalition in wanting to deliver real change on these issues. So thank you for your energy, thank you for your action, thank you for signing the declaration and delivering the